Hey, what's up? Today I want to show you an importance of Dragon Bishop in Sicilian Dragon game. This is a game that I played recently as black and white player, as you can see, is a good player as well. So e4, c5, we entered Sicilian territory. Knight f3, open Sicilian, g6, Dragon. Pushes or continuation of open Sicilian, takes, and bishop g7 is a hyper accelerated dragon. There is another version that we developed, knight f6 before bishop g7, but that's a slower, that's accelerated dragon. This is hyper accelerated dragon. So normal development continues in this game, in Sicilian Dragon game. The main goal of black is to push d5 whenever it can. And the main goal of white is to prevent d5. What's the point about that? Because if black manages to push d5 and comfortably without losing a pawn, then has a good control over center. And usually this game, such games like the Dragon game, or in Sicilian in general, usually goes into opposite side castling, and in that case the one who has a better control can launch a better attack toward the opponent's king. This is why we fight for the center. So normal developing mode so far develops bishop, develops knight, and this is the crucial point. White, after black plays bishop knight f6, it strengthens its e4 pawn defense by playing f3. But this is a bit a slow move because allows black to push d5 that we will see in a moment. And for that reason, many don't play f3. The pawn on e4 is already defended by knight. There is no reason to defend it further. But okay, if there is also reasonable move, but it's not good, it's inaccuracy if it is not a mistake. Castles, brings the queen out, wants to castle queenside and wants to exchange the bishop with white's black squared bishop with black's black squared bishop. But it's a bit late. It's a bit late for this action because d5 is on the board. D5 says, black says that I want to access to the the center, and I want to control the center. It's not only white that can control the center. I can also have a control over center. If white captures the pawn with pawn, then black is happy because nobody controls the center. And in this case, white grabbed the c-knight because was frustrated or whatever. But this is not a good move because opens the b-file. And in particular, if white wants to castle queenside with its arrangement of pieces, says that white wants to castle queenside, developing queen before white squared bishop means that white wants to castle queenside. If white wants to castle queenside, then open b-file is really dangerous for white, and they shouldn't keep it open. But anyways, they kept it open, and then after such moves, after some exchange, black is really happy from the center. And white immediately castles queenside without evaluating possible threats. Well, there is no direct threat. Currently is white actually threatening to win the d5 pawn. But black can simply defend the pawn, but it was possible to ignore the defense of this pawn and directly attack to the king. But that needs very deep calculation that I didn't do it during the blitz game. So first I simply defend the d-pawn. At this moment, black has a very comfortable center. D pawn has no No pawn against it to counter it. So black is very happy with the center. And white starts to launch its attack toward the king side of black. This is a schematic theme that every one attacks to the other one's king if they castle opposite side. So that's normal. Black also says that, okay, I also want to attack your king. White moves the slides away the king to b1. Why white did that? The main reason is that at some point white can move the knight. For example, knight takes d5 pawn, and in this case if black captures the white queen, if king was on the c1, the capture was with check, so white has to recapture. Let me show you what happens. Actually, it's maybe a little bit complicated for those who don't know. For example, in this position, if white wants to play some moves like this, this is not possible at the moment for many reasons, but imagine queen is not able to capture the knight, but instead queen can capture the queen. And in this case, it is a check, and white should respond to the check, and then black has time to capture the knight. But whereas if the king goes away, and for example, let me do something stupid, and in this case, if white moves the knight away, as you can see suggested by engine, black doesn't, and black has to capture the queen, but white can either capture the knight with check or capture the queen, has more opportunities, more choices. Therefore, it slides away the king to not be in a range of queen check easily. But let me go back to the original board. But this opens up new doors for black. Black simply plays rook b8, says that I want to take your b pawn and destroy your king defense. White is not careful at this moment. Just attacks black king, and this is the end of the day. Can you spot the winning move for black? There's only maybe I can say there is only one winning move, and it's not so easy. It's about dragon bishop. The black squared bishop of black is called dragon bishop because it's attacking from a long range to the white's king. Yes, is to release the dragon bishop with threat. Knight e4. White cannot do anything but to take the knight, because if white just moves the queen away, it's attacking the queen, right? If white moves the queen away, then black simply takes the knight with check, and white cannot recapture. And since it is defended with many pieces and the pawn is pinned, so white has to capture it. And with what? Clearly with pawn is not possible, because if white captures with pawn, then black takes the white's knight, attacks the queen, and threatens nasty check at the b2. So what I'm saying is this position, if black ever tries to capture with pawn, this is a killer blow. I mean, either you give up a queen and save your game, or not save your life, or you don't give up a queen and try to save the game, but doesn't help much. Eventually you should give up a queen. You cannot move away because this is a mate. So capturing with pawn is not possible, but capturing with knight is possible. White captures with knight, but of course opened my dragon bishop. I take it, moves the king. No, find the next move. Killer move. First, we take that pawn to say that we want to mate white's king. White mate, because if white doesn't do anything, doesn't move the queen, or doesn't move the queen, or I think the only move is to move the queen. If white doesn't move the queen, then black plays queen a1 and it's a mate. So no, white moves the queen. Then first we remove the defender. The knight. Knight is a very good defender, prevents our bishop to go to c, 3 square, and if knight goes to c3 square, can provide some defensive forces for white. So we remove the defender, attack the queen, and should respond to that. Queen can doesn't have many options, many moves to make, because should defend the c pawn, otherwise it's a mate. Then final blow, bishop a6. Queen cannot take the a6 bishop because rook takes c2 is a mate. My opponent just moved the queen backward and didn't help because it's a mate. And queen also couldn't leave the c pawn defenseless in general, couldn't go anywhere else, because once queen leaves the defense of c pawn, we just take the c pawn and is a mate with the rook and is a mate. So white tried to keep the defense of the pawn for a moment, but it wasn't helpful enough, and we won the game. I hope you enjoyed. Bye.